Good morning, students. This is my lecture number 2 for chapter number 4, The Rattrap of Flamingo book for class 12th subject English. In this chapter, we shall cover the homework solution of my lecture number 1 and then we'll continue with page number 36 to 42 from NCERT book. And then the homework related to the lesson will be assigned to all of you. I assigned you homework given on page number 34 in my lecture number 1. And the first question is, from where did the peddler get the idea of the world being a rat trap? And its answer is, during one of his usual plodding, the peddler thought on the subject of rat traps. It presented him with the idea of the world being a rat trap and he grew fond of thinking this way. The question number 2 is, why was he amused by this idea? The peddler was amused by the idea of the world being a giant rat trap because he was never treated kindly by the world. Therefore, he harbored hard feelings for it and loved to think ill of it by comparing it with the giant rat trap. Question number 3 is, did the peddler expect the kind of hospitality that he received from the crofter? The answer would be no. The peddler did not expect the kind of hospitality that he received from the crofter. This was because usually he was greeted by sore and unfriendly faces whenever he knocked on doors and requested for shelter. Question number 4. Why was the crofter so talkative and friendly with the peddler? Answer is, the crofter was a lonely fellow who lived on his own in a little grey cottage by the roadside. He had no wife or children and craved company and friends. So one day when the peddler turned up at his doorstep, he was happy to find someone to talk to be relieved of his boredom and monotony. This is the reason he was so talkative and friendly with the peddler. Question number 5. Why did he show the 30 krono to the peddler? Answer is, the crofter was a knave and trusting man. Knave means untrained and unsophisticated. And a trusting man who craved company more than anything else. He wanted to share his joy of earning the money with someone. He got his chance when the peddler came along. Moreover, he thought that the peddler did not believe him. So he showed the peddler the 30 kronor bills that he kept in a leather pouch. Let's move to question number 6. Did the peddler respect the confidence reposed in him by the crofter? Obviously, no. The peddler did not respect the confidence reposed in him by the crofter. In fact, he betrayed his trust by robbing the 30 kronors from him. However, later in the story, his conscience was awakened by his stay with the Wilmansons and he decided to return the money. Now, we will proceed with the chapter from page number 36 to 42. But before we proceed, I want to tell you the gist of the chapter or the value points or the highlights that we covered in our first lecture. The story is about the peddler who was a vagabond who sold rat traps with a little thievery on the side to make both ends meet, had no worldly possessions to call his own, not even his name. The idea amused him to think that the world is nothing but a big rat trap. And he takes a shelter at the crofter's cottage. The crofter welcomed him, gave him dinner, shared his pipe, everything. And next morning, the peddler steals the money and takes the back roads to keep away from people and get lost in the jungle at night. While he wanders in the forest, he realizes that he has also got caught in the rat trap and that money which he stole had worked like a bait for him. And finally, he reaches Ramso Iron Works where he takes shelter for the night. Now, we will proceed further with the value points of the story to be covered from page number 36 to 42. The Iron Master, the owner of Ramso Iron Mill, the dialogue between the Iron Master and the paddler, how Edla persuaded the paddler to obey her, the paddler's real identity, the Christmas Eve at Iron Master's home, the paddler's letter which was addressed to Edla. First of all, I'll let you know about the Iron Master, who was the owner of Ramso Iron Mill. In those days, this mill was owned by a very prominent means famous, iron master, whose greatest ambition was to ship out good iron to the market. Therefore, he watched both night and day to see that the work was done as well as possible. And at this very moment, he came into the forge on one of his nightly rounds of inspection. He usually visited his mill at night because he wanted to confirm whether all his workers are working efficiently or not. And then the first thing he noticed in his mill was the tall ragamuffin, who had eased his way to so close to the furnace that steam rose very high from his wet rags. The iron master did not follow the example of other blacksmiths, who gave their haughty consent to this paddler to take shelter at his mill. Being the owner of the mill, he had noticed a new person lying beside a furnace there at his mill. So he walked very close to him, looked at him very carefully, and then he slouched his hat to get a better view of his face. Now we will proceed to the episode which would reflect the dialogues between the Iron Master and the paddler. The Iron Master noticed this person at his forge, went very close to him, and then as soon as he looked at his face, he asked him, "How do you look, dear Nils Olof?" The man with the rat traps got surprised because he had never before seen the Iron Master at Ramso and did not even know what his name was. But it occurred to him that if this fine gentleman thought him as his old acquaintance, he might have perhaps throw him a couple of kronor. Therefore, he did not want to undeceive him all at once. The Iron Master continued with his talks. He said, "God knows things have gone downhill with me. Why have you resigned from the regiment?" Now, the paddler became very confident that this Iron Master was mistaken in identifying the real identity of this paddler. He thought as if this rat trap seller, the paddler, the vagabond was none other than his old acquaintance who was with him in the regiment, and the things had gone worse with him in his life. Then the paddler was invited by the Iron Master to his home because he thought this paddler was his acquaintance and he could not tolerate that one of his acquaintance was in rags, was losing his everything that he had in his life before. Therefore, he requested this paddler to come to his home for his better living. But as the paddler knew his real identity, he could not believe that he was invited by this Iron Master to his home, but he knew to go up to this house of the Iron Master would be like throwing himself voluntarily into the lion's den. He only wanted a chance to sleep there in the forge, and then he wanted to sneak away unnoticed as much as it was possible for him. So he got embarrassed when he got the invitation to visit the house of the Iron Master, and he refused it very smartly because he did not want to put himself in any other trouble. After listening to the refusal, the Iron Master went back to his home and sent his daughter, whose name was Edla Wilmensen, to persuade this peddler to visit their home. In this chapter, now we shall proceed with how Edla persuaded the peddler to visit her home. Edla Wilminson was the daughter of Iron Master. Who had a better power of persuasion? It was not more than half an hour before they heard the sound of carriage wheels outside the forge. A new guest came in the forge. This time it was not the Iron Master, but he sent his own daughter, who was hoping that she would have better powers of persuasion than her father, so she would be persuading this fellow to visit their home. And she spoke very kindly to him. She said her name was Edla Wilmenson. She was the only daughter of that Iron Master. She felt even sorry for the captain that he was having such a hard time in his life. She looked at that fellow very compassionately with her heavy eyes, and then she noticed as if the man was afraid. She had doubts about the paddler. She thought that either this fellow had stolen something or else he had escaped from jail. I repeat, she thought, either this fellow had stolen something or else he had escaped from jail. Even after having these doubts, she wanted to persuade this fellow to visit their home. And to persuade him, she said it was Christmas Eve the next morning and she wanted this man to enjoy that Christmas evening with them. She wanted him to be their Christmas guest. And she made him sure that he would be allowed to leave them just as freely as he wanted. So, she spoke all these things in such a friendly manner that the rat-trap peddler could not decline the invitation and he accepted it willingly. The peddler's real identity, which was revealed in the morning when he was well dressed at the Iron Master's home. The next morning, the Iron Master was very happy to have his old regimental comrade under his roof. He planned to feed him well and give him some respectable work. The servant cut the paddler's hair, shaved him, bathed him. The paddler appeared wearing one of the Iron Master's fine suits. But when the Iron Master looked at him in daylight, he felt that he had made a mistake. The paddler was not Captain Von Stahel. He thought that the man had deceived him. He even thought of handing him over to the police, the sheriff. The paddler now started conversing with the Iron Master when he noticed the expression of Iron Master's face which was not in his favor. The paddler said that he had not pretended to be what he was not. He had not been willing to go to the Iron Master's house. Even then he was willing to put on his rags again and leave. He also told the Iron Master that the world was a rat trap and he himself might have been caught in it. This conversation of the Iron Master and the paddler made Edla surprised and she felt sorry because she planned to serve food to this paddler as it was Christmas Eve. She thought that she would feed this paddler on this great day that would give her happiness. But when she got to know that this man was not the old regimental comrade of her father, she also felt very bad. But she gave a thought onto their conversation and then she came in between and stood and spoke very loudly that this man was invited by them. He did not come as per his own wish, but both the father and Edla forced this fellow to be a part of their house. Now, when he had come under the roof of the same house, then they got angry because it was the result of their misunderstanding. The Iron Master was very much sure that Edla would not let this man leave unless this Christmas Eve got over. And in such a way, Edla convinced her father for the paddler's stay at their home. Her father said that she was really a better preacher than a parson. And the girl felt happy because she was again successful in convincing her father to make this possible that the fellow would be fed by them at Christmas Eve. Then they celebrated Christmas Eve at Iron Master's home. On Christmas Eve, Atla served food to this peddler. He was given Christmas presents, which he thankfully received. Atla told him that her father's suit that the peddler was wearing was also a Christmas present. She assured him that he would be welcomed again if he liked to spend the next Christmas Eve with them. Next morning, the Iron Master and his daughter went to church, and there the man at home was all alone. Adla's kindness had given a knock at the door of the peddler's heart. He felt very happy for Adla's behavior and the kindness she poured onto him. He thought she was really a very kind girl. Even after knowing the real identity about this man, she did not become harsh, but she served the best possible food she could to this fellow on this evening. The peddler wrote a letter which he addressed to Adla. Before this, we must know, when this Iron Master and Adla went to the church, there they came to know that the peddler was a thief. He had robbed the crofter near the roadside. The Iron Master was sure that the peddler must have made away with all their silvers at their home. Adla was dejected. She also got shocked to listen about the real identity of this man. But when they reached their home, they learned that the peddler had left a Christmas present for Adla. Adla got surprised to see that Christmas present. When she opened it, she found it was a tiny rat trap, and Adla was very happy that the fellow had left the stolen amount, those 30 kronors which he had stolen from the crofter's hut. That money was left in that rat trap which was left for Adla. There was a letter also. This letter was addressed to Adla. In this letter, that peddler thanked her for her kindness. He wanted to repay her kindness, so he had left the crofter's money and had requested her to return this money to that crofter. He said he had been raised to captain now. That was why he could come out of the rat trap in which he had been caught. He signed at last himself there as Captain Von Stahel. He made a promise to Adla that from then onwards he would try to become like the captain to whom she served food. This was the overall result of Adla's kindness, that she could transform the rat trap seller, the thief, into a good man. So she felt very happy. After having a look at the gift as well as the letter that was left for her by the peddler. Now, I would assign you homework related to these pages. You are supposed to solve question number 1 to 3 given on page number 37, think as you read. Question number 1 to 5 given on page number 41. Question number 1 and 2 given on page number 42. And on page number 43, understanding the text, question number 4 only. Thank you. Have a nice day.